Beloved, we welcome you to another exciting week on the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. We are embarking on a new journey on righteousness. Of course, I know there's been a lot of new teaching on grace. We don't knock any of that, but I believe that if we understand the righteousness of God, its principles, its requirements, it will put grace and accommodate its reality within the context of personal integrity, holiness, righteousness, obedience to the faith, love for the brethren, and all that the Word of God requires of us. That's a mouthful. But to make it simple, let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 1, 26 through 31. For you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. But God had chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. Hallelujah. Oh, I want to say I am a miracle, beloved, because I am one of those foolish things that had been chosen by God to confound the wise. And God had chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and base things of the world, and things which are despised, hath God chosen. Yea, and things which are not, to bring to naught things that are, that no flesh should glory in his presence. Glory to God. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, that according as it is written, he that glorieth, let him glory in the Lord. Amen and amen. Well, beloved, this is where we want to begin to understand the mysteries of righteousness. The spiritual mystery concerning righteousness is the position it gives us in the realm of the Spirit. That God, through Jesus Christ, paid for our sins and then gave us a position from which we begin to reconstruct our lives by the Spirit of God, by the Word of God, by disciplined living in righteousness. And so, if I do not understand this foundation, by the way, that's why we're calling this the foundation of righteousness. If I don't understand this foundation, that position that the Lord has given me will be jeopardized. Listen carefully, beloved. It doesn't matter where you are. Doesn't matter how well you're doing. It doesn't matter how difficult things may be for you, how challenging your circumstances may be. You need to understand that before the Lord, you owe him everything. You don't deserve anything he has done. You didn't earn it. It is a freely given grace, an undeserving position, wealth, favor and blessing that the Lord your God has freely given to you. When you consider our text, it says, For you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh. There are people that are naturally wise. Watch this. We've read this scripture and we have said, you know, you see, there are some men that are naturally wise after the flesh. And the tendency is to think that those people have some worth in and of themselves. I said, beloved, no, no, no. Even if you are naturally wise, even if you are naturally intelligent, even if you are naturally creative, even if you are naturally a towering beauty or a human specimen of handsomeness, come on, beloved, it was still freely given by God. You didn't do anything to earn it. So that whether you are strong or weak, beloved, you have to recognize that everything you are, or everything you have become, everything you came with to this earth, everything that has worked for you, it doesn't matter how hard you've worked, doesn't matter, I don't care, beloved. It is the grace of God in manifestation in your life. Yet, even within that grace, some of you have advantages over others. I put myself in the category of the weak that became strong. Watch this. He said, you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. Then when you look into the depths of this text I'm reading, the reason the noble, the mighty and the wise are not called, not many of them, is because the natural advantages God gave them, they attributed to themselves. And that pride kept the door of revelation closed. And do you know that the same thing happens to us that have received this grace of salvation and the love of God, and we've received ministries? Some of us are highly gifted and anointed. But as soon as we begin to attribute things to ourselves, our grace begins to diminish. And that position that the Lord has given to us freely by the blood of Jesus will be jeopardized. And now we'll begin to struggle. We'll begin to run into roadblocks and things bigger than us. And God will not be in a hurry to come and visit us, because His glory is being tampered with. Where are you this morning? May God give you wisdom to appreciate Him for all He has done in your life, and all He has given you freely, and all He's getting ready to do as you learn this message. May the Lord bless you. I will continue tomorrow. Apostle, bye-bye.